always say that it is important to eat clean as much as possible. So fresh food and vegetables, freshly prepared food. Avoid processed meat, process anything, because all of this is inflammation which can cause problems with the placenta. As much as possible, eat a balanced diet with a little bit of everything. So meat, fish, vegetables, fruit, carbohydrates, everything. So there will be people who are very restrictive in their diet, vegans or vegetarians, or who are gluten intolerant. And when they don't get all the components that is needed for this baby, there are going to be problems. And then you will need to find alternatives so that they can get these nutrients. As much as possible, try to eat just a little bit more than you normally eat. So the myth is to eat for two. But when you eat too much also goes across to the baby. So a pregnant woman should continue eating healthy and eating just as she would before she was pregnant. There are some important nutrients that are needed in pregnancy that as much as possible you want to try and get from food sources rather than from supplements. The ones that we know definitely make a difference in baby's development are iron, calcium, vitamin D, and DHA. DHA is important for brain growth, but if you eat fish maybe twice a week, that's enough. If you have red meat in your diet, that's the best source of iron. But if you don't, then you should try as much as possible to get non-meat sources of iron into the diet. Calcium usually comes from milk, cheese, yogurt, but if you're lactose intolerant, then you might need a supplement for it. And the most important, now this is not a food, is vitamin D. Vitamin D comes from the sun, 90% of it. But vitamin D is an important calcium transporter. So without vitamin D, the calcium cannot get to the baby for the skeletal growth. And unfortunately, Asian women don't like going in the sun. So they would rather get a supplement then spend half an hour at 10 o'clock in the morning and get dark. But it's important. So the answer to that question really starts before pregnancy, because you want to make sure that you are in best health possible before getting pregnant. If you're overweight, you should lose weight before getting pregnant, because pregnancy isn't the time to start losing weight. If you smoke or drink, this is the time to stop before you start, because then it doesn't affect the baby. You should be taking folic acid already, because what's important is as the baby is developing in the beginning, even before you realize you're pregnant, folic acid is already being used. And if you don't have enough of it, the baby's development can be affected. If you have medical problems, it's important to see your doctor and make sure that it's under control before starting the pregnancy. You might want to change medications that you're taking to those that are safe for you to get pregnant on. But once you're already pregnant, it's about making sure that any problems that come up are detected early and stabilized so that the baby doesn't realize that you have a problem. Once you get pregnant, then you just have to try and make sure that you try to stay as healthy as possible, which means eating clean, eating a balanced diet, and if you have a restrictive diet, have supplementation so that the baby's development is not affected by your diet. Getting some sun if you can't, and if you can't get the sun, get vitamin D supplementation. Exercise all through pregnancy ensures that your blood sugar remains stable. So people who even develop diabetes in pregnancy can ensure a stable blood sugar if they exercise. Make sure that you see your doctor regularly, because then if any problems are detected, they're detected early, they are stabilized so that the baby doesn't realize that there is a medical problem. We are also very fortunate now because we have technology very early in pregnancy to detect or to at least to assess your risk of developing problems in the pregnancy. And so for example, preeclampsia, there are blood tests that we can take that can tell us whether you are likely to develop it later in pregnancy. But not just because we want to tell you that you are high risk, because we have treatment that can reduce this risk or prevent you from getting it at all. So it's important not just to go to your doctor when you're pregnant, but to go to your doctor early enough to try and detect risks early enough so that it may be prevented, completely avoided, or if it does develop, we are prepared and we still try to protect that environment so that the baby develops well. So if you are a woman planning a pregnancy or who is already pregnant, you realize now that your role is more important than ever before and that you must try and protect that environment for this baby's development at all costs because you determine the future.